नमस्कार, आप देख रहे हैं आज डायलॉग विद जेसी। आपके साथ मैं हूं सबीना तामंग देशमुख। आज हमारे साथ हैं एक ऐसी शख्सियत जो चार दशकों से न्यायिक सेवा में लगे हैं। वो जिस राज्य में भी रहे, मामलों को जल्द से जल्द निपटाने की कोशिश करते रहे। ओपन जेल पर इनकी रिपोर्ट को देश भर में काफी सराहा गया। हमारे मेहमान हैं गुजरात हाईकोर्ट में 12 साल जज रहे, राजस्थान विधिक सेवा प्राधिकरण कार्यकारी अध्यक्ष जस्टिस कल्पेश सत्येंद्र झवेरी, जिनसे खास बातचीत की जी हिंदुस्तान और जी रीजनल चैनल्स के सीईओ जगदीश चंद्र ने।
वेलकम टू माय शो।
थैंक यू।
आपने अपना करियर जो है वकालत से शुरू किया, आईएसआई किसमें जाने का मन नहीं हुआ आपका उस समय?
आई एम कमिंग फ्रॉम ए लॉयर फैमिली। माय ग्रैंडफादर वाज आल्सो लॉयर एंड माय फादर वाज आल्सो लॉयर, सो इट्स ऑलवेज बेटर टू बी ए लॉयर। And it's a challenging profession rather than IPS and IAS. Every day you have to be prepared on the subject. Every day at the home you have to be a student. In the court you have to be a teacher. And that's how your life is challenging every day.
तो आपके grandfather स्वतंत्रता सेनानी थे, गांधी पटेल के साथ रहे, तो कभी राजनीति में जाने का मन नहीं हुआ? परिवार में किसी ने कहा नहीं कि इलेक्शन लड़ो?
My father contested before my birth, but thereafter he was in original Praja Socialist Party. Then he thought politics is not cup of is, therefore he is left, and thereafter we never thought of going to politics.
तो उस जमाने में जब वकालत ज्वाइन की थी, क्या सोचा था कि हाई कोर्ट जज बनेंगे, इस मुकाम तक पहुंचेंगे?
I was blessed by one of the high court judge. The day on which I have gone to take blessing when I joined profession in January 83, he blessed me that I will be high court judge. And I think only because of that great judge who resigned in 1977 in emergency, his blessing I have become a judge.
तो आप गुजरात के रहने वाले हैं, तो राजस्थान में रह के गुजरात को मिस नहीं करते?
No, I think when you are given a job to do justice wherever you are a judge. Whether you are a Gujarat or Rajasthan, litigant is litigant. Every litigant is sufferer, and as a judge, I have to serve them.
तो लंबे समय तक गुजरात जुडिशरी में आप रहे, हाई कोर्ट में रहे, तो सबसे बड़ा कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन आपका इन टर्म्स ऑफ जुडिशियल प्रोनाउंसमेंट्स क्या रहा, कोई एक दो कैसे रहे?
इन टर्म्स ऑफ जुडिशियल प्रोनाउंसमेंट, लेट मी टेल यू, आई बिलीव फर्स्ट इन क्विक रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ द मैटर। जो आप डिस्पोजल बोलते हैं, बट आई टेल इट एज ए रेजोल्यूशन ऑफ द डिस्प्यूट। एंड आई वॉज कंसिडर्ड टू बी वन ऑफ द क्विकेस्ट जज इन गुजरात। वेन आई ज्वाइंट जुडिशियरी इन 2004, द पेंडेंसी वॉज मोर देन 1,41,000, but when I left Gujarat it was less than 90,000.
Wow.
And I have contributed a lot for reducing the pendency of Gujarat judiciary.
Koi landmark judgment, koi case? Ishrat Jhan case mein bhi aapne cognizance liya, notice kiya?
Original cognizance which was pending since 2004 I have taken for the first time when I was sitting in Gujarat under 482, and first notice and originally seat appointment was made by me.
राजस्थान में आपको लगभग 1.5 साल हो गया है, कैसा महसूस करते हैं राजस्थान जुडिशरी के बारे में?
राजस्थान लोअर जुडिशरी, आई मस्ट टेल यू, दे आर वर्किंग वेरी हार्ड, एंड आई हैव नेवर ट्रेवल्ड इन द डिस्ट्रिक्ट्स, बट थ्रू वीडियो कॉन्फ्रेंसेस एंड प्रमोटिंग देम, द लोअर जुडिशरी इज सपोर्टिंग हाईकोर्ट फॉर डिस्पोजल एंड ओल्ड मैटर्स दे आर टेकिंग अप ऑन अ प्रायोरिटी बेसिस।
आपकी एक रेपुटेशन रही है, क्रेडिबिलिटी है कि मैक्सिमम नंबर डिस्पोजल आप करते हैं, तो राजस्थान में कैसा अनुभव रहा हाईकोर्ट में?
आई थिंक आई हैव रिड्यूस द पेंडेंसी एटलीस्ट ऑफ द जयपुर बेंच, एंड फॉर इनकम टैक्स आई कैन टेल यू आई एम फिक्सिंग ऑफ द मैटर विद इन अ मंथ और 6 वीक्स ऑफ द करंट मैटर्स विच आर फाइल्ड इन 2018।
कभी मन नहीं करता चीफ जस्टिस बनने का?
इट्स अ सर्विस, एवरी वन ही वॉन्ट्स प्रमोशन, बट इट्स ऑलवेज ऑन ए लक, इट विल कम एट अ राइट टाइम इन ए राइट डायरेक्शन एट
तो राजस्थान
हर कोई की इच्छा तो होती है, इट्स नॉट दैट आई विल नॉट बी हिपोक्रेट, बट यस।
तो राजस्थान में आप राजस्थान विधिक प्राधिकरण के कार्यकारी अध्यक्ष हैं, एग्जीक्यूटिव चेयरमैन, तो आज की तारीख में, आज के समय में इस संस्था की, इस इंस्टीट्यूशन की रेलेवेंस यूटिलिटी क्या है?
यू मस्ट हैव सीन वी हैव रूट रीच टू द ग्रास रूट लेवल। Every district we have our district service authority. We are implementing all central government scheme, state government scheme. Regularly we are holding mega camp. We are helping poor people in getting their ration card, Aadhaar card, your Bhamasha card, every scheme of government. And through Legal Services Authority, Free Legal Aid, we are giving even at the remand stage, we are appointing full-time advocates. They are helping accused right from the remand stage. At least last 4 years, we are on the top of the All India list, and we are either number one or number two for Legal Services Authority.
लीगल एड का नारा है न्याय सबके लिए तो पिछले 30 साल में क्या लगता है इंस्टीट्यूशन सक्सेस हुआ है
दो एक्ट हैज कम इन 1987 लेट अस बी वेरी फ्रैंक अबाउट व्हाट वाज पब्लिश्ड इन 1995 इट हैज टेकन मोमेंटम लास्ट 10 इयर्स एंड लास्ट 10 इयर्स इफ यू लुक एट नाउ वी आर एनहेंसिंग द फीस ऑफ द लॉयर्स वी आर एनहेंसिंग टेकिंग क्वालिटी लॉयर्स And now lawyers are also supporting because of they are getting handsome fees.
कुछ लोग ये कहते हैं कि वकीलों की मोटी फीस भी इसमें एक बाधा है तो उसको
Now I think our Legal Services Authority are paying handsome amount. In High Court we are paying 16,250. At a district level almost 7,500. That is not even charged by the regular lawyer. Now to say that because of the finance we are not getting good lawyers, we are giving the best available lawyer. See, we must appoint a person who is committed to the client, not to his ability. Even if you engage a good lawyer, but he is not committed for the cause, he will not justify the cause of a poor people.
So, Rashtriya Lok Adalat, ye kaisa kaam ho raha hai Rajasthan mein?
Rashtriya Lok Adalat, you look at the figure, we have disposed of a huge number of matters. And there I must give credit to my lower judiciary. They are working very hard and heads up to them. In spite of five annual Lok Adalat, 5 to 6 Lok Adalat, they are working day and night and they are supporting the Nalsa in their noble cause of Lok Adalat.
So Chief Justice saab ke effort ki tareef karte hain.
It's a team work, it's not my individual work, it's ultimately my family. I always consider my to be Karta of HUF and every judicial member is my family. That's how I worked everywhere, whether it is Gujarat or Rajasthan. I tell them I am only head of the family. I am not your boss or I am Karta of the HUF.
So, your relationship with Chief Justice, personally, professionally?
It's all cordial with every judge, whether it is a puny judge or Chief Justice, I am cordial with everyone. Ultimately, it's always, if you are good, everybody is good with you.
Now, you have talked about finance. In terms of state government, you don't get full cooperation in terms of infrastructure, in terms of money release. How was your experience in Rajasthan with the state government and particularly with the Chief Minister?
My 40 days as the acting Chief Justice, I must tell you, I get every support from the government. 40 days, what was our requirement, even for the computer or anything, were done before 31st March of last year. Therefore, if you talk, my individual experience with the state government is good. Yes, it is true that some of the demand of the lower judiciary and is not sanctioned, but that the always finance is their consideration will overcome, because now after this finance commission they are given funds, will resolve it with the state government.
High court mein charcha hai ki aapke aane ke baad mein coordination between the government and the judiciary is improved. Kabhi milna hua CM se? Kaisa?
Chief Secretary and everybody has come when I was acting Chief Justice, and on a professional terms, I convinced them that it is always having a cordial relation which will improve the relation, and it is in your interest to resolve the matter. It is not that every matter you are losing. In some of matter, if you succeed, you will get resolved many a promotion and everything. Therefore, they have realized that it is always better to resolve the dispute rather than having a tug war with the judiciary.
Rajasthan mein kuch landmark judgment aapne ki Kota suicide incidents pe aapne kafi coordination di. Kaise dekhte hain?
Kota, I think it's sub judice. I will not comment, but I have accepted the report submitted by a professional team where students are committing suicide, and I think I have directed state government to make rule on the basis of recommendation made by the professional team, and some of the recommendation are basic requirement. Because students are not machine, they also need 6 hour minimum sleep that they are not getting, and I think that issue is required to be resolved by the state government at a very expedite level. because suicide at every week or every day is a very serious thing for everyone. It's a problem of the society and we must resolve amicably.
So what is the human aspect of this issue, quota issue?
Human approach is that, let me tell you, we parents are responsible. Ultimately, if I am not genius, my daughter or my son is not going to be genius. Ultimately, it is well known. If I am intelligent, DNA will come to my students. The persons, they are not getting 50% mark in their career and they expect their son and daughter to do well. It's always better to tell yours that do better than what I was doing. Don't compare them with the other people. It's always better to do, request your son or the daughter to do better than I was doing because you have better circumstances. But don't tell them you achieve 90%. That's how that expectation from the parents is, they're taking it as a daring, daring. Therefore, improvement is required to be at the parents' end, not at the students' end. They are absolutely a child. They don't know before 18 what to do. They can't even resist. They have to go by the wishes of the parents. Therefore, improvement is required at the parents' end. And one of them, I firmly believe that committing suicide, not the classes, but more is the parents are responsible. They are pressurizing the boy. He can't utter a word. And therefore, he has no other option but to commit suicide.
It was suum auto cognis or somebody had come?
No, in it was a public interest litigation which has...
ये सुम ऑटो कॉम्बिनेशन हम लेते हैं इसलिए कि कुछ लोग सवाल उठाते हैं कि ये कितना उचित है कितना
टेल यू वी आर ह्यूमन बीइंग व्हेन वी थिंक रिपोर्ट समबडी वी रीड सम रिपोर्ट ऑफ द न्यूज़पेपर और समबडी राइट्स अस एंड वी थिंक दैट दिस इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी डन अंडर द स्टैट्यूट एंड इफ इट इज नॉट डन देन इट इज अ ह्यूमन टच ऑफ अ जज विच लीड्स टू सुम ऑटो इट इज नॉट अ इंडिविजुअल जज हु इज स्पीकिंग फॉर हिमसेल्फ but he is speaking on the behalf of the society and taking suo moto cognizance for the society, for the betterment of the poor people who can't utter a word against a powerful person or the authority.
Yes. ये भी कहते हैं कि आजकल कुछ ऐसा ट्रेंड या फैशन हो गया है कि सीनियर जजेस जो सुनवाई करते हैं तो वो वर्बल मौखिक टिप्पणियां करते हैं जो अखबारों के हेडलाइन बनती हैं ये कहां तक उचित है
I now think guys in Jaipur I made a judicial order that now only orders will reproduce no oral comment of a judge will come because it's always a discussion between a lawyer and a judge it's not a proceedings part of proceedings
yes
to take out the best thing it's sometimes you have to give a contradictory illustration but For press and media, it's always better to reproduce only the orders of the court, not the oral observations made by the judge or the counsel lawyer.
तो अशोक परनामी के केस में क्या हुआ है? अखबारों में मैंने पढ़ा कि कुछ कमेंट्स आए थे आपके बेंच से कि
I think the comment made by him was not befitting to be a good leader. We have issued notice and once he has tendered unconditional apology. We have shown our magnanimity.
Yes.
It's always, see, contempt is for to maintain the dignity of the institution. And ultimately, if you don't respect judiciary, no person in the society is safe. Nor even judges, nor even anybody. If you look at even politicians, ultimately they would come to resort to the court.
Yes.
When they are in trouble.
Contempt ka jo concept hai, kai baar log kehte hain aajkal ki. It is an effort to curb the freedom of expression. ऐसा लगता है कुछ
If you have a genuine comment under 19(1)(g), Article 19(1), then I think it's not because even contempt, there is a defense. If it is a truth, it's a defense. Therefore, to say that it is to curb truth is not there. Now it's open for anybody to write if it is truth, but you have to do a research. Commenting on a criminal court. A judge has done this. See, for a judge, he has to consider everything, every aspect of the law. Document placed on record, credibility of the witness, contradiction of the two witnesses, presence of the... Many things are required to be seen, which journalist may not be knowing while commenting on a judge. And to become a judge, it's not that easy. And to judge after becoming a judge is not that easy. It's very difficult because if you look at the evidence which is available, more than sometimes 50 witnesses, and which witness is saying what, it's very difficult to remember. And then to give a judgment, it's very easy to say that judge has committed error. But put yourself in the shoes of a judge and then you comment, it is always better.
PIL के बारे में क्या आपका अनुभव है? क्या लगता है? Is it missing the judicial process sometime?
I think now after Supreme Court judgment, every High Court is controlling the PIL. Well, we are finding that it is a arm twisting, we are not interfering. And where it is, we found that it is a good public cause, judges are interfering.
RTI, इसमें कैसा लगता है?
Right to information, if it is within the right and under the rules, because there are prescribed rules. If it is come application within the rules, even High Court is granting it. Every institution is now covered. Only thing which is not covered is the personal details of the individual employee or the judge. That is not within the area of the right to information. Otherwise, every disposal or everything is available under the Right to Information Act.
Any misuse?
It's always, you are well aware that every action has a reaction. Rules are made, but it's always misinterpreted, and sometimes people are misusing the this act very badly also.
Supreme Court had appreciated your research work in this Vidhik Sahayata Rajasthan. Wo kya issue tha?
Open jail.
Yes.
See, Rajasthan has a unique feature of right from 1958, open jail. And I think it is really a commendable job for the state government or the whosoever has initiated this open jail concept. Is really appreciable in the sense, today if you look at all over India, the jail is not sufficient to keep all persons in the jail. The expenses in the jails are tremendous. And if you look at the accused, majority of the accused of my judicial experience is innocent persons who were circumstances which has compelled him to commit an offense. It is not that he is a hardcore criminal. Okay, he has predetermined and committed an offense. Sometimes in a spur of a moment or a weaker moment, he has committed offense. Therefore, looking to the scenario as on today and public fund which is available with the state government, in my opinion, open jail should be accepted by everyone, and under trial prisoners, those who are under trial prisoners in the jail, unko open jail mein rakhna chahiye.
Bail ke bare mein kya samajh, is it right or a discretion or what? Is pe charcha hoti hai aajkal, bail dete nahi court aam taur pe aajkal.
It's I think judicial discretion. My judicial experience is in a case where there is no direct evidence, bail should be granted. But trial court is afraid of high court. Because in majority of the high court, if the trial court grants bail, they are facing departmental proceedings.
Yes.
Therefore, even if there is a case for bail, the trial court is avoiding the bail. Therefore, I think it's better to find out some solution. But otherwise, bail is right from 1978. Justice Krishna Iyer is said bail is the rule, jail is an exception.
How to sort out this crisis situation?
I think that requires freedom to the lower judiciary. That has to be done by the High Court. It is on administrative side.
और ये क्या लगता है आपको 498 और rape cases में जो कानून है उसका बहुत बड़े पैमाने पे मिसयूज होने की शिकायतें आती हैं, कुछ आप लोग अवेयर हैं इसके बारे में?
I think there our professional brothers are responsible, because parties are not knowing that 498 you have to make allegations. They are creating a story and involving. And as is as usual, every act which is made for an intention is never used for that purpose. It always misused. You look at any act, it is never used for the purpose for which it has been done. But people are finding out an exception and therefore amendment in the act.
अंडर ट्रायल्स का कोई सोल्यूशन? इतनी नंबर है अंडर ट्रायल्स का?
आई थिंक सुप्रीम कोर्ट टाइम एंड अगेन हैज गिवन गाइडलाइंस, इफ इट इज मोर देन 5.5 इयर्स दे शुड बी ग्रांटेड बेल. आई थिंक सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज ट्राइंग इज लेवल बेस्ट. अनलेस देर इज एन अपॉइंटमेंट by the full time facility given to the judiciary, infrastructure, then electricity, computers, staff, all other facility. No judicial can function with without infrastructure. Therefore, central government and the state government both has to specific allocation, and they have to first plan for another 10 years down the line what will be the requirement. They must create infrastructure, including all staff and everything, and they should see that the infrastructure is created and judges are appointed. Have a simple calculation. You calculate from any high court, number of vacancy of judges multiplied 1000, multiplied by the total years, the pendency will be less. I am taking 50% of the pendency of every judge, that he will dispose of only 1000 matter. Even then you take out any high court, the pendency will be nil. Only because the judges are not appointed to the sanction strength, pendency is there.
Rajasthan mein kya ho raha, 15-17 vacancies chal rahi hain, koi plan hai?
It's absolutely prerogative of the Chief Justice, and I will not comment since I am part of a collegium, and it's absolutely for the Chief Justice to consider.
Don't you think there is some communication gap or trust deficit between judiciary and the government? Vacancies nahi bhari ja rahi hain, ruke hue hain appointments.
Isme two things hai. Personally, if you ask me, there should be a regular meeting of a collegium, and there should be a deeming fiction. If the government don't approve, judgment itself has said they don't approve within 6 weeks, it deemed to have been approved. That has not been taken into its right spirit. If that is taken in the right spirit as per the judgment, no appointment can be withheld. It can be cleared. Only thing, Supreme Court judgment is to be implemented.
The basic question is ki supremacy kiski hai, government ki hai, judiciary ki hai?
No, all are equal.
All are equal.
All are equal. They are best in their execution. We are supreme in our judiciary. I think it's unnecessary. People are taking it to be supremacy. All are on equal footing. All the three are parallel, whether it is executive, parliament, or the judiciary. They are supreme there in their own field. Nobody is superior.
Political or bureaucratic quarters mein aajkal aam taur pe kehte hain ki judiciary apni lakshman rekha laandh rahi hai, executive ka kaam kar rahi hai. Kya aapko lagta hai kabhi aisa?
Show me a single thing where we have crossed the statutory provisions. We have interfered only in a case where they are not implementing the statutory provisions, which is will covered under the Article 12 and 226 and 32. If you read, it is writs prerogative only for that purpose, to issue a writ of mandamus or a direction to the authority to do their duties, which are mandatory under the. You look at 39A, constitutional. These directive principles, if they are not implementing free education, if they are not implementing its our duty to tell them this is your duty, you are elected to perform your duty, not to enjoy only your power.
And what about corruption in higher judiciary? Cases badh rahe hain iske?
Corruption, I tell you, it's always a doubtful case in my opinion. Rarely I believe that a judge can be a corrupt. Many times I tell you, the lawyers are taking higher fees or collecting money in the name of judges, because they don't get a higher price. And let me tell you, litigants also, they are prepared to pay higher price in the name of a bribe. They are not prepared to pay higher fees to the lawyer. Therefore, lawyers are also adopting a easier way. Yeah. Otherwise, it's very easy to say that a particular judge is a corrupt, but it's very difficult to believe it.
All India Judicial Service lagta hai kabhi banegi?
It's a government wish, and it's a sub judice matter before the Supreme Court. Therefore, it's better lagta hai ki Supreme Court will decide the matter. It's pending before the Supreme Court.
Aaj sare desh mein Narendra Modi ki charcha hai. Desh videsh mein jaate hain, Modi Modi ke nare lagte hain, lakhon log jutte hain. एक सिटीजन और वोटर के नाते आप नरेंद्र मोदी को प्राइम मिनिस्टर कैसा महसूस करते हैं एज ए सिटीजन?
लेट मी टेल यू, सिंस आई एम फ्रॉम गुजरात, आई विल नॉट ओपन, बिकॉज वट एवर वे आई विल से इट विल बी मिसअंडरस्टूड. But I've seen him working right from 2001.
Yes.
He may be a very decisive leader. People are telling that he's an autocrat. But if you want to work, you have to be a decisive and autocrat. And every person has his own weaknesses. Ultimately, you have to look at whether he is doing good for the country, whether he is gaining himself or his family. If the answer is no, then one has to accept him as a leader. And after all, he is our Prime Minister.
Yes. So, but at the end of the day, ab kya tamanna baki hai? CJ, CJI, Supreme Court?
No. I should be a good human being and should be a good judge, which I continued for almost 14 years.
14 years. And you're absolutely contented with your job.
Absolutely. You will never find right from, even in courtroom, yes. I never comment on. I always go with my all preparation.
And you sound too very enthusiastic. Eh? Very.
That's God gift.
Thank you so much. Best of luck.
Thank you.
जस्टिस झवेरी ने हमसे पीआईएल आरटीआई सेक्शन 498A कंटेंट लगभग सभी मुद्दों पर बात की. आज के लिए इतना ही, लेकिन खबरें आगे लगातार जारी हैं.